episode of 24/7. What did they leave out that you were hoping would make it?
I mean, it's okay. I spoke on it on Twitter. I spoke on it on Twitter, and I said what I said, but HBO, no. Like any relationship, husband and wife have arguments, father and son, brother and sister. Those things happen in life, so we chalk it up, and this week, it'd be a lot more exciting.
Does this fight feel like a huge fight to you? I mean, you've been in some huge fights in your career. I mean, where does this rank up in?
I mean, I can't really say, you know, where the fight ranks, like I said before, amongst popularity or how large this fight is, but I think every time I go out and fight, you know, it's a pay-per-view extravaganza. You know, just to average over, you know, to average 1.4, 1.5 million at home, you know, I think it's truly amazing. And like I said before, it's about having the right team and having the right pieces to make certain things happen in the sport of boxing.
For you personally, what would a win over Ortiz mean for your legacy?
I mean, it's good, you know, to be facing a guy that's, of course, 10 years younger. You know, he's fast, he's strong. Like I said before, it's about getting your just due. And I think eventually, probably 20 years from now, they'll say, you know what, Floyd Mayweather went out and fought the best, you know. And, you know, a lot of times people want to know about USADA. That's the United States. And United States anti-doping, of course, is about being clean, you know. So I've been the first to step up to show the world that Floyd Mayweather is a clean athlete. Floyd Mayweather, for everybody that's listening, I'm not ducking or dodging. No opponent. Any opponent that faces Floyd Mayweather. The same thing happened for the Mosley fight. So I'm not just picking on certain fighters. This goes for every fighter that's facing Floyd Mayweather. You know, in the past, you know, Berto has said that he felt that Victor Ortiz was, you know, he wasn't 100%, you know, when they fought. That has nothing to do with me. But then you say, okay, if he wasn't 100% against you, Berto, why would you go deal with Victor Conti? Okay, so, you know, you look at things and you say, whoa, you know, about the sport of boxing. And then you look at 24/7. Victor Ortiz said that he looked at Oscar De La Hoya like a god, right? But then this is the same guy that first lied to everybody and said the pictures of him was dressed in a drag. He said those pictures wasn't me. And then this is a guy, quote unquote, everybody thought that was perfect. You know, remember, he's the golden boy. You know, an alcoholic, a drug head. And then he also tried to, you know, downplay Tiger Woods, a guy who Oscar De La Hoya know he would never be on a Tiger Woods level. So how could you even fix your mouth to even say that, you know, I cheated, but I'm not a Tiger Woods? You never said anything like that. Me, I'm not hiding from nothing. They say I'm facing a lot of cases right now. Only thing I can do is keep my fingers crossed. And hopefully my attorney team go out there and do the best job that they can do.
But obviously-